The Roman camp of Compendium is in a ferment. The prefect of Gaul, Odius Asparagus, is paying a call on centurion Gracchus Armisurplus. The prefect arrives from the nearby coast where his galley has put in. Present Pilum. Ave, prefect. This is a great honor for me. Ave, centurion. You're telling me. And now for the purpose of my visit, centurion. I am going to Rome on leave, and custom decrees that I take Caesar a handsome present. Something unusual and very valuable. I did think of taking him a present from Lutetia, maybe a marble memo tablet for him to carve down his appointments, but that's too ordinary. Then I had a brilliant idea. Why not take Caesar one of the invincible Gauls from hereabouts? What? But, prefect, about these invincible Gauls, there's just one snag. Well, what is it? They happen to be invincible. That's what makes them so valuable. Get me one of these Gauls, and you won't regret it. There's certainly one who's a bit more harmless than the others. Cacophonix the Bard. He often goes for walks in the forest by himself, looking for inspiration. Excellent. I must have this bard and fast. And in the Gaulish village. Goodbye, Asterix. I'm going for a walk in forest. Goodbye, Cacophonix. No, Cacophonix. Don't go to the forest. I am touched by solicitude, Obelix. It's not that. Only when you sing in the forest you scare the wild boars away. Boar. The boars appreciate my music better than you. That's only natural. You sing like a pig. Barbarians. Savages. In the forest. Go and capture a bard. Go and capture a bard. It's easy to say that. I'm always picked on to volunteer for dangerous missions. It's not fair. Quite. I heard a noise. Take cover. This will be a good place to sing. Maybe it's because I'm Armorican that I love Armorica so. These Gaulish secret weapons ought to be banned by the Helvetia Convention. Right. I've thought of a way to counter the bard's secret weapon. We all stuff our ears. What with? Parsley. There's plenty of it around. Parsley in my ears? I don't fancy that. I'll feel like something OLUT of a butcher's shop. Now, back into ambush. When I give the signal, we all attack the bard. Not up your nose, idiot. Soon afterwards. Now, what shall I sing next? Come on, boys. The others didn't follow me. A fan at last. Someone who appreciates good music. Stop right there, friend. I will now give you a recital. What did he? I'm only a bard in a gilded cage. Stop, stop. I can't bear it, shut up, shut up. Well? Couldn't you hear me shouting, you cowardly lot? Pardon? Phew. That's that. What did you say? Take that parsley out of your ears. Ave, mission accomplished. We captured the Gaulish bard at the risk of our lives, especially mine. Excellent, excellent. There, it wasn't all that difficult. The trouble is we can now expect reprisals from the others. Oh. Well, yes, I really must be going. Fetch my litter. The prisoner and I will leave at once to go on board the galley for Rome. Meanwhile, Obelix, our bard Cacophonix, hasn't come back yet. That's good news, but I don't suppose he'll be long. Asterix, asterix. I saw some Romans capturing Cacophonix. Are you sure, Pecomix? I was out hunting wild piglets in the forest, and I saw it all. What a funny idea of the Romans. Why ever should they want to lumber themselves with Cacophonix? Anyway, we must avenge this insult. I'm off to tell our chief vital statistics the news. Hire. Overtall statistic, our bard Cacophonix has disappeared. You're just saying that to please me. The Romans have captured him. What? By Tutatis, even if it is a funny idea of the Romans, that's not playing fair. We can't have this sort of thing. A Gaul must know how to make his enemy respect him. We shall organize a punitive expedition. Let the druid prepare the magic potion. Soon afterwards, the Gaulish warriors are drinking the magic potion which gives them invincible strength. No, Obelix, not you. I've already told you, you don't need any potion. You're strong enough as you are. What? Me strong? Not a bit of it. I'm as weak as anything. Go on. I'll give you this nice menhir. No, no, and for the third time, no. Silence, our chief vital statistics is going to make a speech. Friends, Gauls, countrymen, we must give these Romans a good lesson by Tutatis.